my slogan, our slogan. It is the pride of Andhra Pradesh. It is the sentiment of the people of Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Vishaka Ukku is Andhra Hakku is the slogan. I request the madam, in fact, madam is the daughter-in-law of Andhra Pradesh, and madam knows Andhra people of sentiment of the people of Andhra Pradesh. I request the Honorable Finance Minister, madam, to kindly reconsider the privatization of Vizag Steel. Madam FM will aware, in fact, madam is aware, as I have told, she is daughter-in-law of Andhra Pradesh. South Indian women, particularly, they won't sell the gold. They won't sell the family gold. Never, never in the case of women. In fact, madam has decided to sell the gold of Andhra Pradesh, that is Navaratna PSU of Vishakhapatnam steel plant, which is very, very unfortunate. It is the sentiment. So I request the Honorable Madam to reconsider. Sir, the central government has the target of 1.5 lakh crore disinvestment next year. As I have told, as I have pointed out, simply selling it PSUs is not the solution. Rather, selling the public sector undertakings formed over years. In fact, when steel plant was formed, probably myself and madam were all studying in the colleges. It is the great effort of many people and that have gone into the PSUs, and because of that, we are inherited to that. So it's an alternative. I urge upon the government to look the alternative resources for revenue generation, such as widening the tax base, etc. and etc., not the disinvestment of a public sector undertaking. So this next issue, madam, standard deduction. I request your good self to increase the standard deduction from 50,000 to 1 lakh, which will benefit many of the employees, madam. Sir, interest rates. Interest rates of saving schemes. Madam, PPF rate was cut from 7.9 to 7.1. Senior citizen savings scheme rate was cut from 8.6 to 7.4. National savings certificate also saw a big cut from 7.9 to 6.8%. Sukanya Samriddhi account scheme rate was cut by 7.6 from 7.6 to 8.4. From 8.4 to 7.6. Interest rate of Kisan Vikas Patra was lowered to 6.9%, which extended maturity period by 11 months to 124 months. These saving schemes are the social objectives, madam. They are meant to create the sense of safety and security for the families. I therefore request you, Honorable Finance Minister, to increase the rates and thereby save the families, living below poverty line and middle class, not the rich and pro-rich. Madam, very important issue which you are not aware, you are not present in the house, and I have brought it, I wanted to bring it to your notice, and now I got an opportunity. Madam, yesterday you have given the reply to the finance bill in Lok Sabha and said that GST Council is responsible for GST and not the finance minister. Madam, Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanam in Andhra Pradesh, I have pointed out, BJP claims to be the torchbearer of Hindus and Hindu temples. I expect this favor from Honorable Finance Minister. Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanam, when pre-GST regime, there was absolutely no GST. Now, after GST regime is introduced, Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanam is paying about 120 crore GST and it can claim back only 9 crores and ultimately the net amount that is being paid is 111 crores. It is charging GST even from the pilgrims who are staying in the cottages. It is not a hotel business. They are all pilgrims, services to the God. So therefore, yesterday, madam, in the floor leader of YSR Congress Party, our floor leader in Lok Sabha, raised this issue of GST with the Honorable Finance Minister, and the reply of the FM was that the Finance Minister of AP is also a member of GST Council. I would like to bring it to the notice of the Honorable Finance Minister, madam. Madam, in GST Council, central government is holding one-third votes. All 28 states put together is having only two-third vote. Eventually, it is the central government which is deciding. And most of the states now, today, are being ruled by BJP, not other parties. And YSR Congress Party can't do anything with single vote. Madam, therefore, I request your good self to kindly consider and grant appropriate relief for Tirumala Tirupati Devasthana. And in fact, your finance minister, madam, is well aware of the coins and foreign currency that is lying, and madam is addressing that issue.
The finance bill. As members from Andhra Pradesh, especially from different parties, have been speaking about this finance bill or demand for grants for the last 7 years since the bifurcation of Andhra Pradesh, the demands have still remained the same, and I would like to just repeat some of them, which are very, very important even today, which is the special status, bridging of resource gap, Polavaram project, formation of railway zone, metro, road, rail projects, establishment of Vizag-Chennai corridor, construction of educational institutions, and many more. So they are still pending on behalf of the central government, whereas financial assistance is required. So through the finance bill also, I would request the Ministry of Finance to speed up this process, as 8 years has already finished since the Bifurcation Act has been started implementation. So I would request the Honorable Minister to release the rest of the funds. But Madam, today I would like to talk about the most burning issue in the state of Andhra Pradesh, which is the privatization of Vizag steel plant. An in-principle agreement has been taken by the cabinet saying that 100% disinvestment should be made in RINL Vizag steel plant. On behalf of Telugu Desam Party and the people of Andhra Pradesh, we totally oppose this decision of privatization of Vizag steel plant, madam, and I would like to present my case by talking about the history of the inception of this plant. Around 7 to 8 years, under the slogan of Vishaka Ukku Andhrula Hakku, which means the steel of Vizag is the right of Andhra, the people of both Telangana and Andhra Pradesh came together and fought with the center for the establishment of the steel plant. 32 people have lost their lives. 22,000 farmers have donated their lands for the establishment of this plant. So today, even if the owners of this plant is the central government, they have to realize that it was made on the sacrifices of the Telugu people, madam. If the central government has a big heart, then they would realize that privatization of this Vizag steel plant is not the right decision. But I see that they have conveniently ignored all the emotions and sentiments of the Telugu people, and they are going with a separate argument. And one of the arguments being made is that Vizag steel plant is a sick unit. I beg to differ, madam. I'd like to place some of the stats on record, where it is between 2000 and 2015, the turnover has been 1.4 lakh crores and profits after taxes of 12,600 crores. And for 13 consecutive years, it exceeded 100% capacity utilization. Vizag steel plant has achieved an all-time high of 1.3 million tons in exports. And recently, in times of COVID also, the workers have worked putting their lives at risk. And December 2020, profit of 212 crores. Jan 2021, 134 crores profit. Feb 2021, 165 crores profit. And this present month, they're expecting 300 plus crores profit. So I beg to differ whenever they say that Vizag steel plant is a sick unit. And the second argument being made by the central government often when it comes to disinvestment of PSUs is that we shouldn't waste taxpayers' money in these sick units. First of all, I explained it's not a sick unit. But the second argument where taxpayers' money is being used, I'd like to present my case here also. Since the inception of the Vizag steel plant, the contribution from the central government to the plant has been 4,900 crores in terms of equity and 1,300 crores in terms of restructuring package. So the total amount given is 6,200 crores. But what has the Vizag steel plant paid back to the central government? It is up to the tune of 43,000 crores. It is five times more than what the central government has donated, has given to the Vizag steel plant. So 43,000 crores in terms of taxes and dividends has been paid back. But what we request from the central government to do to the Vizag steel plant, there are a couple of demands, and these are not demands of just me or the people of Andhra Pradesh. Standing committees have demanded on behalf of Vizag steel plant that they have to be given captive mines. Sale units, other steel plants, they are getting captive mines, they have captive mines, and they are getting per ton of steel at 1500 rupees. Whereas Vizag steel plant, because it doesn't have the captive mine, it is getting at 7000 rupees. And what is this amounting to? VSP loses 5260 crores for every ton of steel it sells, and which is translated to a loss of 2300 crores in the last fiscal year alone. So what we really request from the central government, if they want to help the Vizag steel plant is that they should cater for captive mines for this and provide a level playing field just like other steel plants. And the other thing we are requesting is to reduce the interest rates. When Tata steel plant is getting loans from the banks at 8% interest rate, Vizag steel plant, which is under the finance department, which is under the central government, it is getting at 14%. And this again is resulting in losses up to the fact of 1500 crores just in interest payments, madam. And there are other solutions also. Why not club SAIL and RINL together and try to take everyone in the same line? That is not being done. And when it comes to the exports of this iron ore, 82% of our total iron ore exports goes to China. We are blocking apps from China. We are trying to see that made in India be boosted. Now 80% of iron ore is going to China, and China accounts for all the global steel output. When you have such good functioning steel plants within the country, why don't you give the existing iron ore to them and help them, which is under your own care? So this is what we are requesting. Why show this stepmotherly treatment towards Andhra? And I'm saying stepmotherly because on 16th of March, the Honorable Minister of Heavy Industries, I'll complete in 1 minute, madam. Heavy Industries and Public Enterprises says on the floor of the house that those PSUs which can be revived will be revived. This is a statement from the central government. And where is it applicable? Only in Gujarat, madam. GSPC, which has been a SIC unit, ONGC acquired 80% of Gujarat State Petroleum Corporation for nearly 8,000 crores. ONGC even pays 1,300 crores. So this attitude is being shown to PSUs in Gujarat. Why not to the plants in Vizag? Why this stepmotherly treatment? The central government talks about one nation, one election, one nation, one ration, and so many things which should be in one nation, one constitution. I demand for one nation, one justice. If something is happening from the central government towards Gujarat in a certain way, I would request that also be happening to Vizag steel plant, which is in the state of Andhra Pradesh, madam. If the central government doesn't want to listen to me, I would like to give a cue from the former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji, madam. We really miss him from the state of Andhra Pradesh, especially today, because a similar case of privatization came during the NDA one rule under the Prime Ministership of Vajpayee ji. Then Chandrababu Naidu ji, who was the Chief Minister, and Yerra Naidu ji, who was the Parliamentary Party Leader from TDP, they led a delegation from Andhra Pradesh. They met Vajpayee ji. He listened to the unions, to the leaders, to the people of Visakhapatnam and Andhra Pradesh. He understood the emotions, the sentiments, and he then provided equity to Vizag steel plant. Madam, 30 seconds. He then provided equity which made Vizag steel plant debt free. Thank you.